Hey, Internet!
Hi!
Hi, I'm Andrew.
I'm Crystal.
And welcome to Movie Nights with the Drunk Watch. We're not really sure what we're calling this, so I'm trying that. That sounds pretty good.
I like it, yeah.
Movie Nights with the Drunk Watch.
Yeah.
I like that.
I like it, too.
Co-sign. Put that in pen, Audie. Anyway, 100%. We're the Knights of the Drunk Watch, and now our talk begins.
Okay,
and today
cool.
We're talking about Men in Black International. Which I'm the only one who got to go see this weekend because I had an odd day off. And I'm like, I gotta go see a movie. I thought it was a lot of fun.
Okay.
It's not the best movie I've seen this summer, but it wasn't bad.
I mean, but you go to movies like Men in Black and you don't expect an Oscar winner.
Well, right? No. I wasn't looking for Oscars, but it wasn't as much fun as I thought it would be. I really thought, because it was Chris Hemsworth and Tessa... No, I've forgotten her name.
Yep, her name.
But because I felt like someone saw them in Thor Ragnarok.
Yes,
and I thought, oh, they were so cute together. Let's make another movie with them.
So how was their chemistry in MIB?
I don't think it was as much as I remember from Thor Ragnarok. Okay. So I think that's why it was... I mean, they were both great. Mm-hmm. I mean, the script kind of had highs and lows. So some moments that were really, really funny and were comedy funny, not like physical, like written. Mm-hmm. Yeah, their little sidekick, Pawnee, he was hysterical. So it also has Emma Thompson and Liam Neeson in it.
I love Emma Thompson.
And they are fabulous. And they do a really, they do their bit for the movie and they're great. Yeah. So I can't complain about them either.
That's good.
The movie is going to have some bonuses at the end because Chris Hemsworth is probably one of the most beautiful men on the planet.
Oh my God, yeah.
Chris Hemsworth, I don't feel like he was as buff as he is for Thor. I think he's not doing a superhero anymore. He got to slim down just to be beautiful.
Normal size?
Just normal guy works out because he's a movie star
as
size.
As opposed to
I have to play superhero
Thor.
Size.
Yeah.
And, short hair, clean shaven.
Yeah.
You can really see his eyes.
Yeah.
So.
He sounds so dreamy.
So. And yeah, so I'm going to drink now, and then you'll understand my bonuses at the end of this review. So, do you have any questions?
So, my question is there any connection to the original series?
Just a little bit. Actually, this movie, I guess, relies to a certain extent, I guess, on your knowledge of how the whole thing works. They don't really introduce the MIB.
Okay.
And I don't think it's a spoiler. To say that Tessa's character sees an encounter as a child, because I think I saw this on a preview, as a child, and when they flashed her parents, it didn't wipe her memory.
Her memory.
So she's been, as she's grown up, she's been trying to find the Men in Black, because she wants to become a part of them.
Okay.
All right, so it looks like we've got about 3 minutes left.
Yeah.
So I'm going to give my rating. Now, I'm having a hard time with these ratings, and I'm trying to figure out a way that works for me. And so this is our third one we've done, so we're probably developing this anyway.
Sure.
Like we developed the title, right?
Okay. Yeah.
The rating is how many shots do you need to get through this movie?
Oh, shoot.
Okay. So the more shots, the worse the movie is.
Oh, wow.
Okay?
Okay.
That, I believe, is the standard.
Okay.
Okay,
got
it. So I'm going to give the movie 4 shots.
Oh, my God.
Okay? So that's, for me, that's like maybe 3.5 stars out of 5.
Okay.
So, but 4 shots. Because I think every movie gets 1 shot going in. You want to be a little happy. And, it got a little slow here and there.
Mm-hmm.
And then they have like a great comic part. And then, it kind of fall off.
Okay.
I give it 3 bonus shots for molesting Chris Hemsworth with my eyes.
Oh, my
Because he's just so beautiful.
He is beautiful.
So that's Men in Black International.
How long is the movie?
It's about 2 hours.
Okay.
Oh, I would not recommend spending the money on IMAX. Because I did go to the IMAX, of which there was like 10 people in the whole freaking theater. Even for 12:45 on a Sunday, which was Father's Day, but this is the kind of movie you take your father to. So, and there were fathers there.
Yeah.
But go see it at the regular screen, because if you're going to go to the movies, see it, because it didn't have as many effects. It wasn't I mean, there were special effects, because obviously it's an alien movie, but it wasn't quite as big as Endgame. For example.
Yeah.
So there's action, but the effects aren't so big that you need to see it in IMAX. So I would say save the money on IMAX.
Okay.
If you want to see the movie in the movie theater, it's definitely worth the trip. But if you want to wait for video, you know, if you have a big enough TV, Chris Hemsworth is still beautiful. So I'm going for that.
Yes.
All right, so I guess we should wrap it up. So this is Movie Nights with the Drunk Watch.
Yes.
I'm Andrew.
I'm Crystal.
And now our talk. That's the Drunk Watch. And now our talk has ended. I've only just started drinking.
I know, me too. I don't know what happened. It's Chris Hemsworth. That's what it is.